Good morning, dear student of class 11. Today I am going to teach you your sixth lesson in prose section, The Browning Version, written by Terence Rattigan. About the lesson, you have already seen on your screen. This short one-act play highlights the attitude of a teenage student towards his teacher. His comments are shocking because they are very close to reality. He imitates the voice of his teacher, "My Crocker Harris." He calls the man almost inhuman. He is mortally afraid of his teacher. His promotion depends on the whim or goodwill of his teacher. But he opens up when the other young science teacher encourages him to do so. He hates the Greek play because he doesn't like the teacher's method of teaching. Mr. Crocker. Harry seems to hate people who make an effort to like him. But according to this student, he is still not a sadist like one or two other teachers. He speaks about the poor Latin joke narrated by the teacher. The boy laughed out of common politeness without understanding the joke, but the teacher asks him to explain the joke to the class. Even Mrs. Crocker Harris is not quite happy with his nature. She creates an excuse to send Tableau away. The description of the teacher is damaging. It reflects upon the hopeless quality of some of the teachers. Then we go through the summary of the lesson. The scene is set in a school. It is the last day of school. Tableau, a 16-year-old boy, has come to extra work for Mr. Crocker Harris. He is still in the lower fifth. He is waiting for his promotion to the next higher form class. All depends on the whim of his teacher, Mr. Crocker Harris, who has not yet arrived. As a rule, the class final results should be announced only by the headmaster on the last day of the term or session. But Tableau complains that the rule is followed strictly only by Mr. Crocker Harris, so he will have to wait until the next day to know his fate. He is greatly afraid of his teacher. He had missed a day the previous week's owing to illness, so now he is there to do the extra work. The weather is fine. It is ideal for playing golf. But Tableau does not dare to cut his teacher. He did ask him the previous day if he had declared him fit for promotion. He imitates Mr. Crocker Harris' voice and repeats what he said. He only said that he had given him exactly what he deserved, no less and certainly no more. Tableau can't help saying that Mr. Crocker Harris is hardly human. Suddenly, Tableau realized that he has been rude towards his teacher. He suddenly feels sorry for his audacity. He admits that he got carried away. Tableau is a boy with strong likes and dislikes. He is outspoken too. He plans to take up science. He considers this subject more exciting than the Greek play, the Agamemnon. He calls the play hopeless because of a lot of Greek words used in it, and also because it was not taught in an interesting manner. He admits candidly that he is bitter. Frank, the science teacher, as a grouse that mostly dullards opt for his subject. He encourages Tableau to speak out his mind frankly and fearlessly. Mr. Crocker Harris had promised to reach school by 6:30. He is 10 minutes late already. Frank asks the boy to get away and play golf, but Pablo does not dare to do so. He can't displease his master, although Mr. Cocker Harris never beats any boy. Frank envies him for the effect Mr. Cocker Harris produces on the boys of his class. He wonders why the boys are scared to death of Mr. Cocker Harris. Taplow has some positive things also to say about his master. Mr. Cocker Harris, he says, is not a sadist, not a person who gets pleasure out of giving pain to others. Taplow says that he is better than some other teachers, but he refused to name them. He tries to please Frank also by excluding him from the list of sadists because he is young and also a science teacher. But Mr. Cocker Harris is not a pleasant person inside. He is shriveled up like a nut. He seems to hate people who try to like him. In spite of all the faults, Taplow likes Cocker Harris. He gives an example. The other day, Mr. Cocker Harris related an old poor joke in the class in Latin. Nobody understood it and nobody laughed. Only Taplow, out of common politeness, laughed even though he was no better than others. Mr. Cocker Harris said that he was pleased with Taplow's improvement in the understanding of Latin. He asked the boy to explain the joke to the class so that they too might share his pleasure. Poor Taplow was concerned and he could not say anything. Just as Taplow was relating this incident to Mr. Frank, Mrs. Millie Cocker Harris enters the staff room. Millie, a thin woman in her late 30s, is smartly dressed. She carries a shopping basket which she puts on the sideboard. Taplow gets nervous. He fears she must have overheard his comments on her husband. If she complains against him, Cocker Harris won't promote him to the next class. Millie reports that her husband is the buzzer and may come late. She suggests to Taplow to go to and enjoy himself at least for 15 minutes. To dispel Taplow's fears, she tells him to go to the chemist and bring some medicine for her. She promises to take the blame on herself if Cocker Harris gets angry. Student, these are the summary of the lesson. Some glossary seen on your screen. The hard words. Today your summary section is completed. Next day I will come through a next chapter or next topic. Thank you, student, and goodbye.